Should we start?
Yes, sir.
So we have done with the first part, that is fluid statics. Now we are starting with the new chapter that is called fluid kinematics. Now, if you remember, I made a statement in first or second lecture. So if you remember, force equal to mass acceleration, what was the kinematic part in this? And what do you mean by kinematics? If you remember, this is what? The cause. What is this? The effect. This was called the dynamic part. This was called the kinematic part, and these were connected together with the material property. And this was called the constitutive relationship. Are you clear? So fluid kinematics is essentially studying the motion of fluid. Motion of fluid means, in this case, kinematic part was acceleration. So what all other parameters can be there in kinematics? What do you think?
Velocity.
Velocity.
Kinetic energy.
What else? Velocity. Then displacement.
Yes, sir. Displacement.
Acceleration.
Bernoulli's equation.
Bernoulli's equation is not directly derivable from kinematics as such. These are the motions. कोई भी motion हो रहा है तो what all parameters can you define that motion with? What is the displacement of a given particle? What is the velocity of that particle and what is the acceleration of that particle? So these are the three aspects in which you can actually define or understand the motion of a fluid. And description of this fluid motion is essentially called kinematics. And please remember, जो ये motion हो रहा है उसके पीछे कोई ना कोई force तो होगी. So there will be some dynamic part. But when we are studying kinematics, we are not interested in what has caused that particular motion. So that is how kinematics is different from dynamics. So please don't misunderstand and don't keep a misconception that kinematics as such happens on its own. Kinematics ka reason ek dynamic part hi hai, lekin hum sirf kisko dekh rahe hain jo actual motion ho raha hai. Aap samajh rahe hain? Any doubts to anyone?
No, sir.
So likewise, if you see in your daily life, how do you conduct your lives? You are bothered about kinematics or dynamics in your day-to-day life. When you meet someone, what do you observe? Say the entire class sat for the entrance test. What all you will see? Most of you, what are the marks each student has got? That is the kinematics part. You are not bothered which student studied the most or which students put the most efforts. So that is the dynamics part. And that is why in reality, we misjudge people because we only are seeing the kinematics part. We see what they are doing, but we don't want to find out why they are doing so. Say, for instance, there's a notorious student here who always fidgets with whatever I do here. So I might be interested that this is, I may assign that this student is notorious, but that is wrong on my part, because I should go deep and find out why he is doing so. So what is the dynamics behind his kinematics? And that is also the study that we will follow up this kinematics part, that will follow this kinematics part. But as of today, we will be only interested in the kinematics part, that is how the motion is happening without regarding why it is happening and what is causing that motion. Are you clear? And any doubts? Any doubts to anyone?
No, sir.
So in fluid kinematics, if you had, say, you were to define motion of a rigid body or a solid, how will you define the kinematics of that solid? So this was a particle, you will see how the particle is moving. So you will say this is the trajectory followed by this particle. So it is simple to define displacement, velocity, as well as acceleration of these rigid solid bodies. Now my question is, if fluid is flowing, say this is the fluid flowing in a canal, can you trace each particle and how they are behaving?
No, sir.
So that tells you that in case of solids, this approach works well, but the same approach does not work well if it is a fluid. Because in solids, we have finite number of bodies or particles. But in case of fluid, we cannot have finite number. We have infinite number and we cannot track those molecules at a molecular stage. And if you track finite number of bodies, the way they move, that is called the Lagrangian approach. And alternatively, आप क्या कर सकते हो? आपने यहां पे एक अपना एक नेट लगा लिया, या आप यहां पे ऑब्जर्व कर रहे हैं, सिर्फ जो भी इससे पास करेगा आप उस लिक्विड को ऑब्जर्व कर रहे हो. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड द आलेरिन अप्रोच. सो यू आर नॉट बॉदर्ड अबाउट इंडिविजुअल पार्टिकल्स, यू आर ओनली बॉदर्ड अबाउट व्हाट इज हैपनिंग अक्रॉस दिस सेक्शन. That section can be of some
particular region pe hum focus kar rahe
hain. Haan ji,
ek particular region pe hum focus kar rahe
hain. Ha, ek particular region pe focus kar rahe ho aap. So that's why it is called control volume approach, and Lagrangian is called control mass. That is, you are following a particular mass. That is called control mass approach or Lagrangian approach, and this is called a control volume or Allen approach. Now, can you tell me any example in which you use Lagrangian approach in case of fluids? Can you give me an example in which you use Lagrangian approach in case of fluids? So this was, say, a chimney in Patiala, out of which smoke is coming out. So you want to find out, where does this smoke go? and which region surrounding Patiala or this chimney are impacted the most, then which analysis will you follow? हाँ जी, चिमनी में से स्मोक जा रही है तो आप स्मोक को ट्रैक करोगे कहां जा रही है, क्या पाथ फॉलो कर रही है. यू आर एक्चुअली फॉलोइंग अ काइंड ऑफ पार्टिकल एज वेल, फ्लूइड पार्टिकल एज वेल. सो दिस इज अ लैग्रांजियन अप्रोच. सो यू कैन एक्चुअली यूज लैग्रांजियन अप्रोच इन सर्टन केसेस एंड दिस इज वन ऑफ दोज एग्जांपल्स. That is in case of tracking pollution. जैसे अगर आप एक नदी है और यहां पर एक फैक्ट्री थी, वो कुछ डिस्चार्ज कर रहा है नदी में, तो आपने देखना है कि रिवर के कौन से रीजन मोस्ट इंपैक्टेड हैं. तो यू विल ट्रैक दोज डिस्चार्ज मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड वेर एवर दे गो यू विल फॉलो देम. So you are following actually a Lagrangian approach in this analysis. And clear hai? Kisi ko koi doubt? Now let me know one thing. We have found that Lagrangian approach has one disadvantage, that in most of the cases we cannot follow each and every particle. So it is not advisable to go for Lagrangian approach in most of the practical conditions, except certain conditions where there is no other approach possible. Now let me know what could be the drawback of islander approach. We have found that it is good because we only need to concentrate only on a section or region in space. We need not go at different location or follow this. So you might have seen when the police challans someone, one way could have been that each car is being followed by a policeman. So that is Lagrangian approach. The other is island approach, that is there's a police post here, and whichever car passes through this post, they check the documents of that car. And actually, administration also follows this island approach, not this Lagrangian approach, because this is not possible. So island approach is beneficial, but my question is, why there are certain limitations to this approach, and what are those? हाँ जी बताइए
सर. हम लोग एक पर्टिकुलर रीजन पे फोकस करते हैं, तो फिर हो सकता है उस पर्टिकुलर रीजन या उससे अलावा दूसरा कोई रीजन कंसीडर करेंगे तो वहाँ पे मोशन हम लोग को अलग मिले.
तो एक तो ये हो गया अगर आपने रीजन करेक्टली चूज नहीं किया. आप समझ रहे हो, अगर रीजन ही आपने कुछ और चूज कर लिया जिस रीजन को आपको स्टडी करना चाहिए था, दैट इज वन ऑफ द ड्रॉबैक्स. बट that can actually be dictated by your common sense and your experience. So I'm not taking that as a disadvantage. What else? Think about it. I'm giving you a hint. All the developed laws are for what?
Lagrangian approach sir, particle ke liye.
For Lagrangian, because when you say force is equal to mass into acceleration, or you apply any kind of law, that is actually a Lagrangian description of that physical phenomenon, because that law is applicable to a given mass or a body or a particle. But in case of islander approach, you are fixing a region, so inherently you don't have the laws compatible or developed for primarily or originally for island approach. So you need to convert the Lagrangian format to ILNF format so that you can apply those fundamental laws of nature. And you clear? And fluid mechanics. In fluid mechanics, this is a very important topic in which we convert from Lagrangian to Eulerian or back Eulerian to Lagrangian. So this is why if we are using Eulerian approach, that is very good. But then what we will have to do is we need to reformulate or repackage these laws so that now they are applicable for control volume. Originally they are applicable for control mass, but we want to make them applicable to control volume. So there are theorems which convert either of the two into each other. Are you clear? Any doubts to anyone? किसी को कोई भी डाउट? So I'm putting it here for your benefit. You can quickly read this out. I'm giving you only 1 minute so that you can reinforce your understanding. So this is about Lagrangian. So study the motion of an individual fluid particle or group of particles as they move through space. So advantage is physical laws apply to matter and hence directly to system. Another advantage is the system approach is needed if we are interested to studying the trajectory of particles over time, for example, in pollution studies. And the disadvantage is we get differential equation. So those are very difficult to solve. So we essentially get partial differential equations after this analysis. And those are literally very difficult to solve. And this is what is the description of Lagrangian. Likewise for Eulerian approach or control volume approach, this has a widespread practical application. The only disadvantage is physical laws apply to matter, not directly to regions of space. So we need to perform some transformations to convert the physical laws to laws which fit to Eulerian approach. And clear? Any doubts to anyone?
Sir, when we do the fluid flow analysis and the fluid flow simulations, so sir, in that case, we have to like first regenerate the meshing model of any object. So sir, that is like the Lagrangian approach which we are following.
We need to do meshing, you are saying?
Yes, sir. Like we analyze what would be the different node points or the certain points through which
what is that
partial differential equations will flow through. So, okay. Sir, that is a Lagrangian approach.
No, when you do meshing means you are actually dividing the domain into smaller subdomains.
Yes, sir.
So, you are converting the big control volume to small control volumes. That is called meshing.
Yes, sir.
So, again, you are following Eulerian approach only. Okay. The only thing in meshing you do is you are actually subdividing the entire domain into smaller subdomains.
Yes, sir. But like the analysis of the fluid flow simulations, like through a vessel or through a pipe, which has been meshed, that happens when we supply the partial differential equations of the flowing system through the node points of these mesh.
Okay. So now please remember, I'm coming to that point also. When you apply Lagrangian approach, you get partial differential equations.
Yes, sir.
And when you integrate this partial differential equation for each control volume,
yes, sir,
you get an integral equation.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And this is what you do in your CFD and all the software packages also do this, the same thing.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. So is it clear now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I do that, sir. Hence, I was asking.
Okay. So, very good. So, you have started early. So, that will benefit you a long way. So, please continue with that because this will help you out a lot.
Yes, sir.
So, related to that, what you are talking is, I will be coming to that also. So this is a pictorial diagram that gives you the overview that what is the difference between a contour volume approach and a system approach or Lagrangian approach. So what you are able to see is, if you were only bothered that what is the effect of this obstruction, then contour volume approach is much simpler. Because then what you will do is you will confine this obstruction with some contour volume, that is imaginary contour volume, and simply measure the velocity field at the periphery. Because your objective is only that how does the airflow gets impacted with this obstruction. But had you been given the task that you need to build up this foundation or this stand, then you will have to do this Lagrangian approach. That is, you will have to follow and see what kind of contours or what kind of streamlines. We will get to know what are streamlines. And this is called your system approach.
Yes, sir. मैं इसलिए पूछ रहा था, जैसे सर मतलब हमने spoiler design किया है and we are testing it in a simulation of a wind tunnel या फिर जैसे हमने rotor spoiler design किया है किसी boat का और उसके water में हम देख रहे हैं. तो सर जो उसका first iteration है, जो हमने पहले अपनी design बनाई है, तो उसको जब हम टेस्ट करते हैं तो हम हर फ्लो जो जा रहा है या जो स्ट्रीमलाइन बन रही है हम उसी की तो स्टडी करते हैं, ताकि हम वेट रिडक्शन या टोपोलॉजी ऑप्टिमाइजेशन या मतलब उस कैड को करेक्ट कर सकें. तो यूलियर मतलब जो दूसरी अप्रोच है वो तो काम नहीं करेगी ना सर, लैग्रांजियन ही तो यूज करनी पड़ती होगी हमें.
नहीं, लैग्रांजियन इसमें भी तो आप कर सकते हो. मैं क्या कह रहा हूँ, एक्चुअल में आप एग्जाम्पल में बोलूँ, सो प्लीज रिमेम्बर Lagrangian and Allen approach, they become equivalent, and I will show how. Ab example main aapko batata hu, I will come to that. Say this was, I am showing you here. So this was the particle of fluid. I have one particle of fluid here. So this moves to this location in some time, say t, or say time delta t. So this is how you are tracking a particle. Are you clear? So you're defining displacement of that particle, you are defining velocity of that particle, you are defining acceleration of that particle. Now if I ask, हाँ जी,
ये सर ये Lagrangian है ना, ये वाला जो आप बता रहे हैं?
हाँ, ये Lagrangian बता रहा हूँ आपको मैं. लेकिन इसको मैं बता रहा हूँ कि ये आयलैंड के कैसे इक्विवेलेंट है. अब आयलरेन का क्या मतलब है? सो प्लीज रिमेंबर, आयलरेन मींस यू डिफाइन अ फ्लो फील्ड. व्हाट डू यू मीन फ्लो फील्ड? सो व्हाट डू यू मीन फील्ड फर्स्ट? फील्ड का क्या मतलब होता है
सर? इमेजिनरी डोमेन ऑफ
इन्फ्लुएंस.
यस सर.
सो इफ दिस वॉज सम बॉडी एंड आई से दिस इज अ फील्ड ऑफ दिस बॉडी, व्हाट डज दैट मीन? द इफेक्ट ऑफ दिस particle is felt in this region.
Yes, sir.
Are you clear? Now, if I ask you, I am asking you a question, say this was a body and say this was the field of influence or the field. So, if I ask you what is the flow field? So, say this is a magnet. So what will be the variable function here? क्या चीज होगी यहाँ पे? Magnetic field will be a variable here.
Yes, sir.
So at any location, I can define a value of
B.
B. And you clear?
Yes, sir.
This is field. And this is called an island approach. You are looking at a given volume at a single instant, and you are simply saying this is the magnetic field here. You can define magnetic field at every location. Likewise, say if the fluid was flowing in this channel, so this is the flow field, you are able to define velocity for each and every point. And now if I say Lagrangian approach, so this was the particle, say, this was the particle, I'm tracking this. So t equal to 0, this was at this location. At t is equal to 1 second, this was at this location. At t is equal to 2 seconds, this was at this location. T equal to 3 seconds, this was at this location. Now, if I ask you whether the Eulen approach and Lagrangian approach are equivalent or not, can you shed some light on this? How these can be equivalent?
Sir, अभी जैसे इन यूलेरियन अप्रोच यू सेड कि वी आर लुकिंग एट अ स्पेसिफाइड फील्ड एंड अ स्पेसिफाइड वॉल्यूम सो अभी जो लैग्रेंजियन आल्सो यू डिस्क्राइब्ड उसमें भी वी आर लुकिंग एट दिस रिस्ट्रिक्टेड फ्लूइड फील्ड ओनली ये फ्लो हो रहा है
ओके तो जो आप जैसे आप एग्जांपल बोलो आप वेलोसिटी जैसे डिफाइन करते हो यू डिफाइन वेलोसिटी व्हाट इज वेलोसिटी dx / dt
यस सर
से द वेलोसिटी ऑफ दिस पार्टिकल इट मूव्स अ डिस्टेंस dx in time dt so you can define the velocity of particle as distance moved by particle divided by dt can you define velocity in similar fashion case of Eulen approach because you don't have any kind of particle
no sir
so what happens is so please remember you can assume these particles of fluids as neutrally buoyant neutrally buoyant means उनकी सेम डेंसिटी है तो अगर किसी पार्टिकल को मैं वेलोसिटी डिफाइन कर रहा हूं तो उसी इंस्टेंट पे आर्डिनरी अप्रोच के हिसाब से भी वेलोसिटी वही होगी फ्लूइड की
यस सर
सो आर्डिनरी अप्रोच एंड लैग्रांजियन अप्रोच दे आर इक्विवेलेंट इन दैट सेंस सो व्हेनेवर यू आर डूइंग सम काइंड ऑफ एनालिसिस एंड आई एम कमिंग टू इट You need to choose on what model are you applying those laws. So I'm coming to those. Wait for a second. So this is very important and this is the crux of entire classical science or entire classical mechanics which you have studied and which you will study. So koi bhi subject aap padhte hain This is the common thread in all the subjects, be it electronics, be it anything. So please remember, we are fortunate enough that we are dealing with what are called conservative laws. That is, we already know that nothing can be created, nothing can be destroyed. These can only be converted to some other forms. So that is our benefit and any kind of physical fundamental principle either could be based on mass conservation, momentum conservation or energy conservation. There could be some other conservations also, but mostly in fluid mechanics you deal with these three kind of conservations. Now in case of Lagrangian approach, You can easily apply mass conservation, momentum conservation, and energy conservation. So please remember, in case of fluids, you have four such models on which, when you apply these physical laws, you get the corresponding governing equations. Those are called continuity equation in case of If you apply mass conservation, if you apply Newton's second law, you get momentum equation, and that is also called what you will study, Navier-Stokes equation. And energy conservation is given by your energy equation. So, जो भी physical laws हैं, पहली बात ये आपने ध्यान रखना, physical laws are laws. That are operating in nature, and we know that in all those laws, one thing is common, that something is conserved, and that something, in case of fluid mechanics, most of the time is either mass conservation, momentum conservation. Momentum also can be linear or angular, and energy conservation. And these are the only three fundamental laws that are applicable here. And when you apply these laws to different models of flow means, because in case of fluid, you cannot actually track a particle as such. So you want to choose, or you require to choose, on what system or control volume will you apply those laws to. And those are called models of flow. So when you apply these conservation laws to models of flow, you essentially get these fundamental governing equations. And these are the equations which, when coupled with boundary conditions, finally gives you temperature, pressure, velocities, and all the other variables you require. And please remember, it is the boundary conditions that play the key role in dictating what kind of pressure distribution, temperature distribution, or some other distribution do you get. For instance, if I give you an example here, I've given this example previously also. You throw a ball to freely fall. You throw a ball in horizontal direction. In both the cases, force acting is mg. So that is conservation of linear momentum. But in both the cases, you are getting different trajectories. What is the reason? In both cases, there's conservation of linear momentum. Then why are you getting different trajectories? What is causing the change in trajectory?
Sir, the horizontal force.
So initial or boundary conditions. So please remember, when you apply conservation laws to models, you get governing equations, which can be differential equations or integral equations, like you got here. But the final field, in this case, velocity field, acceleration field, displacement field, will depend also on what? Initial and boundary conditions. So that is very important. So it is as simple as you have some operating laws in which something is conserved. Then you apply those laws to certain models of flow, and you get the governing equations, which can be differential equations or integral equations. And you can solve those differential or integral equations by coupling them with the initial and boundary conditions. And finally, you will get the flow field, in which you can get the pressure, velocity, and if you get the temperatures as well, if you solve the energy balance. So these are the four models of flow that are commonly used in case of fluid mechanics. And these are nothing but basically variants of Eylen and Lagrangian approach. So let me know, what is A? What kind of approach is this? Lagrangian or Eylerian? A. You have fixed a finite control volume, and you are analyzing whatever is flowing past that. So what kind of approach is this? Eylerian or Lagrangian? What kind of approach is this?
Sir, कौन सी बोली सर दूसरी आपने?
मैं कह रही
हूँ। सर दूसरी वाली है वो E से नाम था जिसका।
So this is Eylerian approach.
Yes, sir.
What is this kind of approach? You have a finite control volume. but that control volume itself is moving with the fluid.
Sir, Lagrangian.
So this is Lagrangian. And the third one is a differentially small control volume fixed in space. What kind of approach is this? Eulerian. And again, a differentially small volume moving itself with the fluid. This is Lagrangian. Can you
second value, sir, jo uska naam hai Eulerian
approach. This is Eulerian, this is Lagrangian. Now can you identify both of these? I have called them Eulerian and I have called these two Lagrangian. What is the difference between these two and these two? In dono mein kya difference hai? Dono Eulerian hai, isme difference kya hai? What is the difference? In one case, I am concentrating on a finite. So that is important. Finite size control volume. So final equation for this will be in integral form. That is, when you apply these laws to a fixed finite control volume, you will get integral equation. That is integral equation of conservation of mass, momentum and energy. Alternatively, had you applied the conservation laws to this differentially small control volume that is fixed in space and fluid is passing through it, you will get differential equation. Likewise, in this case also you will get integral equation and in this case differential equation. So these are the four models. Four models ka matlab kya hai? Ki aap wo laws kis pe apply karoge. To ye char cheeze hain aur charon se answer jo aayega wo same aayega. So that is the beauty of this. So whichever route you follow, whether you apply these conservation laws to any of these four models, you will end up in same governing differential or integral equations which are equivalent to each other. So jo isse aayegi equation wo ek integral equation hogi. Us integral equation ko agar main differentiate kar dunga, what do I get? I will get equivalent differential equation. Differential equation ko integrate kar dunga, mujhe ye equation mil jayegi. So all of them are interconvertible. So this is how you apply these laws. So I am now doing a little bit of mathematics that will help you to appreciate how we can convert from Lagrangian approach to Eulerian approach quantitatively. Say you know that force on any particle is equal to mass of the particle into acceleration of the particle. That you know from Lagrangian approach. That is Newton's second law applied to a particle. And this acceleration a particle is change of velocity of the particle with respect to time. That also you know. So in Lagrangian approach, the velocity of particle depends on the location as well as the time. So velocity of the particle is depending on what are the coordinates. For instance, so this was the pipe in which fluid was flowing. So this was the particle. So the velocity and acceleration of the particle will depend what is the location of the particle and after what time are you looking at the particle. So this is the velocity of the particle. Now you know that because velocity is a function of x, y and z and t, so you can know, you can solve from your basic that change in velocity will be equal to curly v by curly x into dx plus curly v by curly y into dy plus curly v by curly z into dz plus curly v by curly t into dt. So that is the definition of total derivative. That is dv. Now if you divide by dt, you get all of them divided by dt, and finally what you get is this term. So this is what you get after you have used the simple derivative concept. That is, a particle was equal to dv by dt, and dv by dt you can find out like this. What I have already
because ye equations are variation in time and variation in space ko represent kar rahe hai na.
Ha, kyunki jo v hai wo function hai, aapka pata hai, v is a function of x, y, z and t. So if you want to write down dv, you know that curly v by curly x dx and all that, because it is function of four variables. And here is particle with everything, because we are still in the Lagrangian approach. Now what you know is, if instead of particle, if this was the fluid and you were tracking this particle, say, you also know that at this location the particle velocity and the fluid velocity are the same, because particle is itself the fluid particle. So please remember, when particle is the fluid particle itself, and that is also called neutrally buoyant particle, then what I know is that I'm putting it here, please remember, then particle, if I say this v particle, then becomes the velocity of the fluid itself. So that is how you convert from Lagrangian to Allen approach. So here this acceleration of the particle, which was, this was something Lagrangian, you could define this in this format by simply, what you are able to see is you have dropped the particle here, because now what has happened is u particle is equal to u, v particle is equal to v, w particle equals to w. U v w are components of capital V, that is ui plus vj plus wk. That is the x, y and z components of velocity. These are u, v and w. So what you see is this neutrally buoyant particle can be actually assigned, the velocity of this neutrally buoyant particle can actually be assigned the corresponding velocities of the fluid field itself. And here is how we convert from Lagrangian to Allen approach. So please remember, there is a subtle difference in the two. So I'm putting it here so that everything is clear. If you have dv particle upon dt, you know that curly v particle upon curly x dx particle upon dt plus curly v particle upon curly x, sorry, curly y, I should have put here curly y only, into dy particle upon dt plus curly v p by curly z, and this is dz particle upon dt plus curly v particle by curly t into, this is dt particle upon dt. Yes, this should have been this. So this is the Lagrangian approach. In the Allais approach, the particle is replaced by the flow velocity itself. So that is what is being done. So what is here is dv by dt, and this is also called like this. So this becomes equal to curly v by curly x. This becomes dx by dt plus curly v by curly y dy by dt plus curly v by curly z dz by dt and curly v by curly t dt by dt. And you get finally, you know that dx by dt is u, that is x component of the flow field. This is v, small v, and this is small w. So you get finally u curly v by curly x plus v curly v by curly y plus w curly v by curly z plus curly v by curly t. This is equal to the material or total derivative of velocity, and this is called the total acceleration. This is called the convective acceleration, and this is called the temporal acceleration. Convective means this velocity change is occurring because the fluid itself is moving from one location to another. And that is how this is the corresponding equation for Allais approach. This was for Allais approach also, and this was for Lagrangian approach. So there is very subtle difference, that is, instead of particle, we are assigning the flow velocity. And that is the subtle concept that you need to consider.